know the world isn't fair, and some are more equal than others. And no one has control over circumstances of birth, but a nation renowned for respect and justice and fairness. Well, it's not just sour grapes, Arthur, it's snobbery. It's an open and shut case of daylight robbery. Whilst the bunting's flying and the flags are waving high, one of the richest women in the world in her own right is paying her way, upwelling her weight from a birthright built on rape and pillage of the poor. History is repeating itself before our very eyes. It's all cloak and dagger, it's all smoke and mirrors. Then the patronage of charity is a thinly veiled smokescreen. In fact, a parasitic queen, it's obscene to me. That whilst the bunting's flying and the flags are waving high, one of the richest women in the world in her own right is paying her way or pulling her weight. From what I see, struggling to pay the bills, or signing on or queuing at the food bank, or shivering in a bus stop on your way to work, you've got to ask, look at the facts. Can a coach load of foreign tourists be worth your tax? Counteract the argument of the purist, or does it seem obscene that whilst the bunting's flying and the flags are waving high, one of the richest women in the world her own right is paying her way or pulling her weight in respect to the rest of us who are scared of the future and what it may hold, losing our pensions, being repeatedly told that we're all in this together and together we'll pull through. But the words are ringing hollow and I don't believe they're true.